You need a bongo? There's bongos back there.
Seriously?
I'm a pretty mean bongoist.
Rainn Wilson is, of course, known for his absurdly brilliant portrayal of power dork Dwight K. Schrute on The Office.
I'm going to be your new boss.
What you might not know, however, is that Wilson is a pretty serious music fan. He writes about bands all the time on Twitter. He also played bongos in Weezer's cover version of Joan Osborne's One of Us. And he recently was embroiled in something of an indie rock controversy when he, Wilson, came up with the name for Weezer's new album. He came up with the name Raditude, which has been widely ridiculed in many circles. Pitchfork went so far as to call it ridiculous.
Just a stranger on the bus trying to make his way home.
This is the land of candy and unicorns.
I recently spent some time with Rainn on the set of The Office for a profile we're doing for Nightline, and in his trailer, he told me the current Raditude controversy is preposterous.
If the Weezer just came out and their new album's called Raditude, people would be like, oh yeah, it sounds like a new Weezer album, cool, you know? But it's like, if you had heard that I had named, you know, let's say, John Stamos named Nirvana's new album Nevermind. People would be like, oh, that's a stupid name. You know what I mean? Or like Tom Selleck named the new Stones album Goat's Head Soup. It's like, oh, that's a stupid name. These are, you know what I mean? There's names and correlation are like, okay, hey, Charlie Sheen named, you know, Radiohead's new album In Rainbows. People would be like, oh, give me a break, In Rainbows. That's stupid. It happens to be like the best album of the last decade.
How long have you been an indie rock fan?
Well, you know, growing up in suburban Seattle in the early 80s, a friend of mine made me a tape of The Clash. London Calling. It was like 1982. And it completely changed my life. And I literally wore that cassette tape into the ground where it snapped, and then I had to get some scotch tape and like try and tape the cassette tape back together so I could, and so in the middle of Wrong Umboyo. Yeah, it works. It would go, this is a Wrong Umboyo, and then it would continue on.
Wilson played a drummer in the movie The Rocker, but the instrument he played as a kid was the bassoon. An embarrassment we discussed when I visited his house for part two of our Nightline interview.
Was the bassoon the genesis of your interest in music?
The bassoon was a really pathetic waste of a couple of years. When I was in junior high, I really wanted to, I was a clarinetist. And I was like, oh, clarinet is great, but this tenor saxophone, that is where it's at. It's so cool. You're honking and soloing and John Coltrane, you know? And so I went to my band teacher. I really want to play tenor sax. Oh, we're so filled up with tenor sax. You know what you should play that's even cooler? I was like, what? Bassoon. Really? Yes. You can be the only bassoonist at Kellogg Junior High School in Seattle, Washington. It's gonna be so awesome. It's like 7 feet long, and you sit on a strap, and you build your own double reeds, and you have to soak them in your own saliva for like 20 minutes at a time. And it's this giant instrument, and even though you blow in it, and it's about this loud. It was a giant chick magnet.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You did well with it?
It was horrible. It's a horrible torture.
Some kid out there is feeling the pain right now.
I know. Someone that they suckered into being a bassoonist is like,
Seems to me Rainn's done all right since his bassoon days. By the way, one last indie rock note. The bands that Rainn likes right now, he says, are Frightened Rabbit and the Handsome Furs. He says he finds bands like the Dirty Projectors and Animal Collective a little bit precious. Man after my own heart.
Nobody calling on the phone. Except for the Pope, maybe.